Hey YouTube, this is DEFCON 3 Security, take 6, I swear. In the course of filming this video, I've had people come up to me, I've had distractions, and I literally had a cat try to jump in my window, saw that I was in the window, and then jump back out. I wish I would have got some of that on video. I would have just kept the camera rolling. So today's topic is, what do officers, police officers, think about security guards? Well, you know, I've had the pleasure and displeasure of talking to many officers, and I get to hear their side of the story and what they actually think of guards. You know, the thing is with guards, there's actually more guards in the world than there are officers. There's more guards in America, security guards, than there are officers. Having said that, we play a key role in being people that observe and report. So our main duty is to observe a crime being taken place and to report the facts of the crime. And who do we report these crimes to? Well, when you call the police, you report the crime to the police, and it helps them in their investigation and to catch the perpetrator. The problem is when security guards overstep their boundaries. You know, a lot of times, and I think we're all guilty of it. By no means am I saying I'm not guilty, but a lot of times you'll have guards that overstep their boundaries and they'll chase a guy that stole something, or they'll get mouthy with that person, or they will try to insert themselves in a cop role in order to try to de-escalate a situation. I can't really give you my opinion on any of that. Sometimes I feel like, well, maybe I guess I am giving you my opinion. Sometimes I feel it is necessary to exert your authority in order to de-escalate a situation. Chasing somebody, I can't really say that's okay, because at the end of the day, you're not getting paid enough and you have no backup to help you if things go south. So having said that, my conversations with officers, you know, I asked them, so what are your thoughts on security? A lot of times, one of the first responses I get is, well, you know, I was a guard myself for 10 years. And I find this a lot. A lot of officers I talk to have worked in the security industry for 5, 6, 10 years. And then they find out they love that industry and they go and start interviewing to become law enforcement. So, you know, a lot of them don't hate on us because they've been in our shoes. They know what the job entails. A lot of them will tell you a lot of what security does parallels what police officers do. You know, you've got different type of guards. You've got unarmed guards who just kind of walk around the mall, and then you've got guards that are armed and are put into rough areas, and it almost feels like you are doing police work every day. If you're at some rough area, as I have been often, and for those of you who've seen my old videos with my body cams, you know that I've been through some really crazy scenarios that even officers might shy away from. So, you know, having said that, cops don't like that. They really don't. They would rather you just observe and report. So when I do talk to them, they respect security officers, but the ones that seem to follow the rules. They don't really want you impeding in their investigation more than just observing and reporting. I've talked to officers and had major things go down, and they haven't been too supportive of me. You know, they'll ask me, well, you know, did the lady point a gun at anybody? My answer, no. Did she physically touch anybody? No. Well, then we have no means to arrest her, man. Sorry. And you can see that they are clearly agitated. As I had a scenario before, and some of you guys have seen it. Lady came to one of my stores I was guarding with a gun. And since she didn't point the gun at anybody, they had to let her go. And the officer seemed clearly agitated that I called them, you know, and it didn't make sense to me. You know, a lot of these officers are, they're not as sharp as I am or you are. as far as the way they hold themselves, the way they dress, the way they act. You know, you do get a lot of immature officers, but at the same time, you get a lot of professional ones too, right? And I'm sure it drives them absolutely crazy when you get top flight security guards that try to impede in their investigation and interject themselves in a situation where an officer is talking to somebody. And I've seen this happen plenty of times. A cop will be questioning somebody and another guard will be watching, and it gets closer and closer and closer. And next thing you know, that security officer is trying to question the suspect as well. Like, so wait a minute, man, you said you were here, but then, and I'm thinking, bro, just shut up. This cop is trying to trick him into revealing information. It's not that the cop is not smart. He's just playing reverse psychology. So I'm sure that drives cops absolutely crazy. Now, I've been in situations where younger cops were trying to de-escalate a situation. This was only a month and a half ago. And they could not de-escalate this guy. So I came in with all my wisdom and I de-escalated the situation. And the cops saw that I was doing a good job. So they let me roll with it. You know, we had one guy, he was drugged out. He had a firearm in his waistband, which we found after the fact. But he kept talking crazy, and you know, and I started to like pretend like I could relate with him. And I'm like, yeah, man, last time I did some drugs like that, it did the same thing to me. And truth is, I didn't do any drugs. But you know, I started to relate with him, and he started to calm down. And he's like, is that right? And I'm like, yeah, man, I mean, it happens to all of us. So do me a favor, man, why don't you just, you know, go get yourself checked out. And you know, I could see that the cops were clearly taking a kindness to the way I was talking to him, and they were like, well, cool, this guy's actually doing a good job de-escalating. But you know, that's kind of a, you got to be careful, because you don't want to, like, again, impede in their investigation or make things worse or incriminate yourself by getting them to say something that could potentially get you sued or them sued. So, you know, the bottom line is, it's a love-hate relationship. The problem is, the cops don't want you to be a liability. And quite often, untrained guards can be a liability. So, that's the biggest thing, is just to make sure that you stay out of their hair. You do your thing. Let them do their thing. You know, another thing that's a pet peeve is a lot of security guards will call for non-emergency things. You know, we have guards that call up and say, hey, dispatch, we've got another cat stuck in a tree. And I'm sure that drives officers crazy, especially when you have the same guard who can't seem to handle his post and calls police for every little thing. You know, that's got to drive them crazy as well. So, you know, the bottom line is, you're just a regular citizen in their eyes. You have no arresting powers other than what a common citizen will have. And you're armed. So that can be a threat to them or a liability. Ultimately, if you ask any cop what they think about security, they're going to tell you, no, they're cool, and but reality is, nah, they do look down on you. I could say this from experience. I can say this from talking to other officers. At the end of the day, just stay in your lane, man. Try to stay out of their hair. Let them do their thing. You do your thing. You know, you're not getting paid enough to put your life on the risk. And the bottom line is, you don't have any backup. If crap goes down right now, I'm going to be on my cell phone trying to talk to dispatch to get an officer here. Whereas an officer can just radio in and have 50 cops on the scene within seconds. So there you go, guys. You know, bottom line is, it doesn't matter what they think of us. It's how you feel about yourself, right? How you value yourself and others around you. As a guard, I highly value myself. I have dignity, integrity, and honor, and that's why I dress nice. I try to keep myself clean. I try to appear professional. Regardless of what anybody thinks of security and community as well, I will come out and give my 110% every day. All right, guys, Thank you. This is DEFCON 3 Security. Like, comment, subscribe. There's more videos coming out. If you have any questions, throw it in the comment box. You know I'm very responsive and I'll answer your questions. Otherwise, I'll keep pushing videos out there as ideas come to my mind. Be safe. Know your worth.